In this video, I will show you how to perform a stable multivibrator using IC555 timer. This is the circuit of a stable multivibrator. In this circuit, it consists of two resistors, that is R1 and R2, and two capacitors, that is C and C1. The pin number 8 and 4 are connected to plus VCC, that is of 5 volt. Here R1 is connected between pin number 8 and 7. Likewise, R2 is connected, it is of 10 kilo ohm, and capacitor C is connected between pin number 6 and ground, and capacitor C1, which is of 0.01 microfarad. This is ceramic capacitor. On ceramic capacitor, it is written as, or it will be written as 103, and this is connected to ground. This circuit, once we apply this DC voltage, this circuit continuously generates the square wave, which is having T on and T off. We have to design the value of T on and T off, and the value of T on and T off depends on the value of R1, R2 and C. In this formula, we can see that the T on is given by this formula. Once we substitute the value of R1, R2 and C, we will get the value of T on as 0.076 second. Likewise, we have to calculate the value of T off using this given formula. Hence, the total time is 0.145 second. That turns out to be almost 14 Hertz. Now, let's do this practically. Here on the breadboard, we can see that 555 timer IC is connected. Here at pin number 4 and 8, instead of regulated power supply, we have connected 9 volt battery. This is for the sake of convenience. Instead of battery, you can also connect a regulated power supply. And the resistors R1, R2 and capacitor, which is of 10 microfarad, is connected. Here at the output, we have connected a LED. LED is blinking because of at pin number 3, we are continuously getting or obtaining the square wave. Whenever we get T on at pin number 3, the LED gets on, and whenever we get T off at pin number 3, this LED gets off. We can also observe this waveform on the CRO. Let's connect this to the CRO. I am using the DSO. It is having positive and negative. I will connect this negative to the ground of this circuit, and I will connect this positive to the pin number 3 of 555 timer. Now press the auto set button on DSO, and also press measure button on the DSO. Here we can see that since the LED is blinking, it is blinking because of the square wave waveform which is obtaining at pin number 3. This is T on, this is T off. Whenever we get T on, the LED gets on. Whenever we get T off, the LED gets off. And we are getting continuous square waveform which is of frequency 14.6 Hertz.